शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुतिस्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मीति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखन्नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः त्वदेवाहं नमस्त्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Does everyone have trouble with audio? Are others able to hear me?
Yes, clear, sir. Very.
Yes.
Can someone tell Padmanabhanji? Let's continue with the Pata. Okay, so. साक्षिणो नानात्वेपि एकेन ब्रह्मणा ऐक्यम संभवति। साक्षी हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम जीवा हु इज साक्षी। तो उभयत चैतन्यम इज साक्षी वेर एज जीवा इज विशिष्ट चैतन्य और अवच्छिन्न चैतन्य। सो हैविंग एस्टैब्लिश दिस नाउ साक्षीज आर मेनी बिकॉज देर कैनॉट बी अनुभव ऑफ सुख दुख विच इज साक्षी प्रत्यक्षा। देर कैनॉट बी वन साक्षी अदरवाइज यू द सेम साक्षी वन साक्षी और द अदर साक्षी। हाउ मेनी साक्षीज आर देर? एज मेनी साक्षीज आर देर दोज मेनी अनुभवाज आर देर। हैड दे बीन वन विद ब्रह्म देन देर वुड बी सुख दुखादि अनुभव फॉर ऑल वेन वन हैज। सो इट वुड बी a very different kind of a situation which is not there in anubhava, thereby sakshis are many and thereby sakshis are not one with brahma, because brahma is one, sakshi is being many. Sukha dukha pratiti is there only for one upadhi, whether you call it as upadhi or whether you call it as visheshanas, however you call it, sukha dukha pratiti is per antakkarana, it is not across antakkaranas for any sakshi. Thereby, sakshis being nana, there cannot be aikya with Brahma. Sakshi Brahma aikya asambhava. To this, the Siddhanti is answering, sakshino nanatvyapi ekena brahmana aikyam sambhavati. There is possibility of aikya with one Brahma, even though sakshis are many. Yaduktam sakshina anekatvad ekatvacha brahmanaha अनेक साक्षिणाम एकेन ब्रह्मणा ऐक्यम न युज्यते। यदि युज्यते तर्हि ब्रह्मणा इव साक्षिण अपि सर्व शरीर वर्तित्व व्यापकत्व एकत्व सिद्ध्या युगपत सर्व शरीरेषु सुख दुख साक्षात्कार प्रसंग इति तन्न। सो व्हाट वाज ऑब्जेक्टेड एज साक्षी बीइंग मेनी दे कैन नॉट बी वन विद ब्रह्म बिकॉज हैड दे बीन देन लाइक ब्रह्म दे वुड ऑल्सो हैव सुख दुख अनुभव ऑफ एवरीवन at the same time. So Ishvara Hiranyagarbha is said to have sukha anubhava of all shariras simultaneously. That's why people do upasana to become Hiranyagarbha, which is another name for Brahma. But with upadhi, of course, all the samashti antakkarana upadhi. Now that samashti antakkarana anubhava is not there for any sakshi. It would have been had it be one with Brahma. Therefore, what was said using this as a reasoning, what was said as Aikya is not possible, Advaita is not possible, Tanna, that objection is not valid. Why? Yataha Sakshi Dvividha. Sakshis are also two types. Ishvara Sakshi, Jiva Sakshi Cheti. There are two Sakshis. Ishwara Sakshi and Jeeva Sakshi. What the Purvapakshi is looking at, he said that Sakshi has to be one, Jeeva's Sakshi has to be many. Just give me one moment, there is some noise here. So Purvapakshi is using the Siddhanta and says that I know what you are going to say, that Sakshi is different from Jeeva. He had initially, further he had mentioned that. But the Siddhanti established who is a Sakshi, who is a Jeeva. Because Purvapakshi may be using the words without knowing the connotation. What is the proper meaning of Jeeva? What is the proper meaning of Sakshi? It should be established before Purvapakshi's words can be taken at face value. You cannot take it at face value. It has to be analyzed. So it was established. Now the objection of Aikya is looked into, and there the Sakshi is also of two types. If you say Sakshi cannot be one, there is Ishwara Sakshi and Jeeva Sakshi. What is the difference between the two? Tatra Adhya Eka Eva. Ishwara Sakshi is one. You can say Ishwarascha Asau Sakshi Cha or Ishwaratva Sakshi. Either way you look at it, that is one. Because there is no difference between Nirguna Brahma and Ishwara. It's the same entity with the Maya Upadhi, without the Maya Upadhi. With the Ishwaratva Upadhi, without the Ishwaratva Upadhi. So this Sakshi is one. And Jeeva Sakshi, Dvitiya Aneka. The Jeeva Sakshi is definitely many. We accept that. Parichinnascha, we also say is this Sakshi, Jeeva Sakshi is limited. Because the Antakkarana Upadhi connection is there. As an Upadhi though, there is a connection limited by the Parichinnascha. Tathapi Vyapaka Brahmano Na Bhinnaha. Even if the Jeeva Sakshi is Parichinna and Aneka, there are many Jeeva Sakshis and Parichinnaha, still Vyapaka Brahmana Na Bhinnaha. They are not different from the Vyapaka Brahma. How so? Yatha Ghatakasho Nana Parichinnapi Mahakashad Ananyataya Mahakasha Swarupa Eva Bhavati. Tatha Jeeva Sakshi Nana Parichinnapi Tattvatah Brahma Bhinnataya Brahma Eva Bhavati. Just like Ghatakasha is not separate from Mahakasha, even while having the Upadhi of the Ghata or the Matha, the Ghatakasha, Matakasha are same Akasha. Tattvata, there is no difference. Similarly, here also, there is no difference. Although they are Parichinna, Parichinna by Upadhi means that Upadhi Sambandha is not there. So they are not really Parichinna. Shuddha Swarupa of Sakshi is Chaitanya, and this Ishwara Sakshi is also Chaitanya Swarupa. There is no difference between Chaitanya. It has already been said that there is no Pramana for Chaitanya Bhinnatvam. So Sukha Dukha Deo Vrityaruda Sakshi Vishayaha. Now you are talking about Sukha Dukha, which are Anubhava of Sakshi limited to one Antakkarana, not across Antakkaranas. For that, the analysis begins. Sukadukkadayaha Vrityaruna Sakshi Vishayaha. The Sukadukha Anubhava that we talk about is Sakshi Pratyaksha, alright. But when we say Sakshi Pratyaksha, it does not mean that the Vrittis are not there. Vrittis are there. Only with the Vritti connection, the Sakshi knows the Sukadukha. The aham sukhi, aham dukhi, ityadi pratiti yasti. Whatever anubhava is there, that I am sukhi, I am dukhi, it is possible only when there are vrittis. Only through the vrittis, the sakshi has the pratyakshatvam of sukha dukha. Thereby vrittis being there, there is nanatvam. Otherwise, Chaitanya, Sakshi, when he is not connected with any vritti, there is no difference at all. So, Sukadukhadayaha Antakkarana Vrittehe Na Vishayi Bhavanti Iti Yaduktam Na Etadasti. Now, he goes back to the analysis which was done earlier, which the Siddhanti didn't bother about because there is some technical difference there. what was said as the antakarana cannot objectify itself, vritti cannot objectify itself, but still there is another vritti which can objectify the vritti. What is said is that this vritti cannot objectify itself. We do not agree with that. The vritti, while going away, so we'll see, the analysis here is slightly different, but then what was said earlier, and there was no discussion done on that because there was a set of Puropakshi questions. And the Puropakshi had explained, it was not clear whether Puropakshi or Siddhanta, because we agreed that Siddhanta also says so. Technically, tarka-wise, it seems okay that vritti cannot objectify itself. It cannot objectify antakarana. Antakarana cannot objectify itself. Because to objectify the vritti, the basis should become clear. The foundation should be objectified. So, sukha-dukkhadayaha antakarana vrittehe na vishayi bhavanti yaduktam na etadasti. In a general sense, it is right that the vritti cannot objectify itself, it cannot objectify antakarana. We agreed there, but now when we are talking about sakshi, the situation changes because sakshi is separate. So, sukha-dukkhadayaha antakarana vrittehe na vishayi bhavanti iti yaduktam na etadasti. यद्यपि सुख दुखादया साक्षी भाष्यः तेज साक्षिणः नाना तथापि न केवल साक्षी सुख दुखादीन भासयति किंतु वृत्ति द्वारा एव दिस साक्षी हु इज द रीजन फॉर द अनुभव ऑफ सुख दुख दैट इज नॉट डायरेक्टली इवन व्हेन वी से केवल साक्षी व्हाट वी मीन इज दैट देयर इज नो Indriya involved there. When other things ghatadi pratyaksha, ghatapatadi pratyaksha bhavati, that time indriyas are involved. So when kevala sakshi is meant, that time it is not that the vrittis are not there. Vritti dvara eva, the pratyakshatvam of sukha dukkhadaya is also due to vrittis, where the sakshi is vritti aruda. So here it is said, तथा ही यदा अंतकरणस्य सुखदुःखाद्याकारः परिणामो भवति तदा एव अंतकरणस्य अन्यापि वृत्तिः सुखदुःखादि विषयक ज्ञानाकारा भवति. What happens is that at the time यदा अंतकरणस्य सुखदुःखाद्याकारः परिणामो भवति, अंतकरण takes the सुखाकार. That time तदा एव अंतकरणस्य अन्यापि वृत्ति, देयर इज अनदर वृत्ति विच कम्स अप विच इज सुख दुखादि विषयक ज्ञानाकार, बिकॉज देयर इज सुख दुखाद्याकार एंड देन सुख दुखाद विषयक ज्ञानाकार. दि ज्ञान वृत्ति इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दि विषय वृत्ति. दि विषय गत एंड दि ज्ञान गत प्रत्यक्षत्वम देयर इज अ डिफरेंस. So that Siddhanti is explaining now, because in ghata patadi also, ayam ghataha versus ghatam aham janami, there is a slight difference there. The based on the triputi, triputi in the sense the triad of the Chaitanya segmentation, as though what becomes one with the other, based on that, there is Vishayagata Pratyakshattvam or Jnanagata Pratyakshattvam. So there is an analysis done here as to Tathahi Yada Antakkaranasya Sukadukkhadyakara Parinamo Bhavati Tadayava Antakkaranasya Anyapi Vritti Sukadukkhadi Vishayaka Jnanakara Bhavati. That's why I know that Aham Sukhi. Tadrusha Jnana Rupa Vrityaruda Sakshi Sukadukkhadin Prakashayati. The Sakshi who is Vrityaruda. So Vrityaruda Chaitanya. Sakshi Chaitanya. Vrityaruda Chaitanya. Or Antargata Chaitanya. Either way it is can be explained as to the Vritti. Which kind of a Vritti? Tadrusha Jnana Rupa Vritti. There is a Jnana Rupa Vritti. See, Jnana Rupa Vritti and Sukha Dukha Rupa Vritti is different. Jnana is about Sukha Dukha. Therefore I can objectify Sukha Dukha. Sukha Dukha are not part of me. Nayayika say that Sukha Dukhas are atmantargata. Sukha dukkhas in the Vedanta Siddhanta are not atmantargata because Shruti refutes it. Shruti rejects that sukha dukkhas as qualities of atma. They are objectifiable. What happens here is tadrusha jnana rupa vritti. The sukha dukkha vishaya. Vishayaka jnana. There is a vritti which takes the jnana akara. Which jnana? Jnana regarding the vishaya, regarding the sukha dukkha. So tadrusha jnana rupa vrittyarudha sakshi chaitanya. So chaitanya which is riding the vritti or is one with the vritti, is underlying the vritti. Sukha dukkhadin prakashayati. That reveals the sukha dukkha. Anyaritya sukha dukkhadaya sakshino vishayi bhavanti. Anayaritya, not anyaritya, anayaritya. Anayaritya sukha dukkhadaya sakshina vishayi bhavanti. And in this manner, sukha dukkhas are vishaya to the sakshi. That I know I have sukha. So this is the process here of how sukha dukkha becomes sakshi pratyaksha. Vrittimantara tu na kevala sakshina vishayi bhavanti. Without the vritti, there is no kevala sakshi pratyakshatvam the way the Purvapakshi understands. Purvapakshi is told that vritti is definitely involved and vritti is not objectifying the vritti. The jnana vritti is objectifying the vishaya vritti. There is a difference between the two. So, sakshi chaitanya which is underlying the jnana vritti, sukha dukkhadi vishayaka jnana vritti, that sakshi reveals the sukha dukkha by phala vyapti, and then the sukha dukkha is known as being there in antakkarana. This is the process. Anaya rītya sukha dukkhadayaha sakshina vishayi bhavanti. Vritti mantaratur kevala sakshina vishayi bhavanti. Not without the vritti. When we say kevala sakshi, there sakshi pratyaksha does not mean that the vrittis aren't there. Iti hi prachina granthakaraha ahu. This is how the earlier granthakaras talk about how the sukha dukkhas are vishayas. Atra etad akutam. What is the idea here? Idea is following. If this is technical, it is very difficult to understand. He explains what exactly is the process. Little detailed now. Kevale api akashe ghatakasha iti nama jalaharanadikam karyamcha ghatarupopadhi drushtimanu pratiyate. When we talk about ghatakasha, even if there is only kevala akasha is there. Kevala api akashe. There is no ghatakasha, but ghatakasha usage is there. When there is one ghata which has something and another ghata which does not have something, we have to differentiate between the space in one ghata being full and the other ghata being empty. There is space, but there is space in the other ghata. In the earlier ghata, there is no space because it is full of something else. Such vyavahara is possible when we differentiate between the ghatakasha and Ghatakasha 1 and Ghatakasha 2. Otherwise, Vyavahara is not possible. But just because we have Vyavahara does not mean that Akasha is really Bhinna. Ghatakasha iti nama kevale api akashe nama bhavati. Further what? Karyam api bhavati. What karya? Jala aharanadikam. You can fetch water using Ghata and this Ghatakasha, there is space for water to be filled in. So if you fill it half, if someone says, do you have enough, more space for water? Yes, I do have. Ghatakasha, does it have ghatakasha? In that ghatakasha, is there really more space for water? There is nothing called as more space. There is no called as space within the ghata. Space is one and the same. Akasha is same. So the karya and the nama is used. Considering what? Considering the ghata rupa upadhi. So the perspective is based on the ghata, not based on the akasha. There is no real segmentation in akasha. The drishti is with the ghata upadhi. So ghata rupa upadhi drishti manu pratiyate. there is an appearance of ghata akasha and then thereby jala jala aharanadikam karyam cha pratiyate. Oh, this, there is not enough space, this, you know, you, this spot is small, I cannot fetch enough water because this is, this has very less space. The, a bigger ghata will have bigger space because I can, I mean, it has bigger space, I can fetch more water, it has more utility for me. Natu tam upadhin drishtim vina. Without that upadhi drishti, you cannot say that there is less space, more space, one space, second space, you cannot make such segmentation. Upadhi drishti bhave tu akasha eva kevalah pratiyate. Without the upadhi, if you look at space as a whole, you cannot look at segmentations in akasha. Ataha ghatakasha api mahakasha eva. Ghatakasha is also mahakasha. Vikarasya vacharambana matratvena mithyatvat. The vikara, which is seen as ghatakasha rupa vikara, matakasha rupa vikara, kumbhakasha rupa vikara, all those vikaras are just names. Vacharambana matratvena mithyatvat. Vacharambana vikaro nama mithya it is. Upanishad says that, Chandogya Upanishad says that, vacharambana shruti. Why? Because mrittika ityeva satyam, tini rupani ityeva satyam, trini rupani ityeva satyam. So, when rupas are analyzed, then you look at the rupa in the karya and then you come to the karana rupa. Some karan, some analysis is given with trivit karanam. So, everywhere, whatever rupa you see, all those rupas are mithya, the karana rupas are satya in comparison. Then, karanam satyam, karyam mithya. This is established. Why? Because karyasya karana abhinnatvat. Because karya does not have any satta other than the karana satta. What is the difference then? Vak is different. The nama is different. So vacharambana matratvena mithyatvat karyasya mithyatvat there. Here also the same reasoning is used that vacharambhana matratvena mithyatvat ghatakasha mahakasha, these are upadhikruta bhedas, they are vikaras created by the vak alambanam yasya. Arambhana is alambana, ralayor abhedaha. Repha and lakara are used interchangeably, we see it in many languages also. Even kids, you know, when they say ra, they may say la also. So vacharambhana is vakalambanam. The all these vikaras are not really vikaras. They have their beginning in speech. Only when you utter or because of word difference, there is vikara, but there is really no vikara, mithyatvat. Due to vacharambhana matra, there is nothing more than, there is no real vikara. Ghatakasha and Mahakasha. Ghatakasha is not a vikara of Mahakasha. The vikara is a pratiti. It is mithya. When you do not have upadhi drishti, then kevala akasha drishtya, Mahakasha, Ghatakasha api Mahakasha. Similarly, Sakshi is Brahma. There is no difference. Evam eva sakshat shuddha chaitanya matram Sakshi. Sakshi is nothing but shuddha chaitanya. Iti nama sukha dukkhadi dharmashrayantakarana prakashakatva rupa karyancha antakarana rupa upadhi drishtim manu anusrutya eva pratiyate natu tam vina. So this pratiti of sakshis being nana is also looking at the upadhi drishti. Sukha dukkhadi dharmashraya antakarana is the substratum for sukha dukkhadi dharmaha. That ashraya, which is antakkarana, is lit up. Lit up is known. Sukha dukkhadi dharmashraya antakkarana prakashatva rupa karyancha antakkarana rupa upadhi drishtim anusrutyaeva pratiyate. Natu tam vina. So drishti has to be seen. Segmentations of sakshis is also from the antakkarana upadhi drishti. And Prakashatva Rupa Karya also is considering that Antakkarana Rupa Upadhi. Without that, there is no possibility of difference in Chaitanya. Sakshi is another name for Chaitanya. Natu Tam Vina. So if you are keep on looking at Antakkarana as an Upadhi, talk about Sukadukhadi, which are only due to Vrittis, with Vritti Sambandha we make Chaitanya as separate, but Sakshi is really not connected with any of these Upadhis. That's why they are called as Upadhis. Otherwise, they would have become Visheshanas of the Sakshi. Sakshi has nothing to do with them. Really, Sakshi is Shuddha. Thereby, even if Nanatva talk is there, that is looking at the Upadhis and you are holding on to the Upadhis, says the Siddhanti to the Purva Pakshi. If you take away the Upadhi, where is the difference? The Anubhava argument is all right, but only from the Upadhi argument. When you take it as there is connection, but that connection is Mithya, because Karya is all Mithya. All the Sukadukha Pratiti is Mithya. Antakkarana is Mithya. When you understand Vedanta Siddhanta, this Mithyatva cannot bring real Bheda in Chaitanya. There cannot be multiple Sakshis if you look at, if you understand that the Karya Vikara, all the Antakkarana and Antakkarana Vikaras are all Mithya. Because of what? Same reason. Vacharambhana Matratvena Mithyatva. So, Upadhi Drishtya Bhavetu Chinmatra Brahma Eva Kevalam Bhasate. There you cannot even use the Sakshi as the Shabda, because Sakshi needs a Sakshyam. Subject needs an object. You cannot say, oh, subject is Kevala. Subject cannot be Kevala. Sakshi also, we say Kevala Sakshi. When we say Kevala Sakshi, it is to differentiate between that subject from the Pramata in the Triputi. Sakshi is not one in the Triputi. He is not one in the triad of Pramata, Prameya and Pramiti. Sakshi is separate. That's why we say Kevala Sakshi. But Kevala Sakshi does not mean that this Sakshi is multiple. Sakshi is separated out from the Pramatru, and when we talk about Sakshi without the Upadhi, then it is Brahma. So Upadhi Drishti Abhavetu, only Drishti, you don't even have to take away the Upadhi. Physically Upadhi need not be taken away. It is a cognitive change. When you, this Jnanena Moksha means there is a cognitive change in the Buddhi. Wherever the Drishti was, that Drishti changes. Drishti which was going outward is inward. Then there is no outward or inward Bheda also. Outward inward Bheda is there only as long as there is no Mithyatva Nishchaya. So for Mithyatva Nishchaya, this outward inward with the Sharira Drishti, Upadhi Drishti, Bheda is done. Then Visheshana stops to be Visheshana, it becomes Upadhi. When Upadhi is understood, Upadhi is Mithya. Visheshana anyway isn't there, all these are Mithya. Then the outward inward Bheda cannot be done. When it cannot be done, subject-object division is long gone. Subject-object division is gone, then Shuddha Sakshi word is used. But Shuddha Sakshi needs a Sakshyam. When Sakshya is also taken away as Mithya, where is the word, where is the possibility of the use of the word Sakshi also? To make Nanatvam. Nanatvam bahu duram. Sakshi word itself cannot be used. So when we say Sakshi, Purva Pakshi may not understand it. That's why these words are used only in Siddhanta to differentiate between the Jiva. Who is a Samsari? Sakshi is not a Samsari. If Sakshi really had Sukha Dukkha, then Sakshi would become a Samsari. Sakshi is not a Samsari. Sakshi reveals the Sukha Dukkha being there in the Antakkarana. Thereby, Sakshi Pratyaksha word is used along with the Vritti taken into account. And also called as Kevala Sakshi because Indriyas are not there. Having said that, Sakshi word itself is not to be used later. Saksham also goes away. When the Shruti also says Kevala Sakshi Nirgunascha, then that Shuddha Chaitanya is the meaning there, differentiated from the subject-object triad, the Pramatra Chaitanya. Pramatra Chaitanya is not the reality of Jiva. The reality of the Jiva is not the Pramata, Jnata, Shrota, Manta. So to differentiate that, Sakshi word has been used. Is Sakshi is there only as long as Sakshya Triputi is there. Now this Sakshi who is separate from the Triputi, when analyzed as Chaitanya and the Triputi as Mithya, then there is no Sakshya. If there is no Sakshya, Sakshi word also drops off. It is Brahma. Thereby, Upadhidrishtya Bhavetu Akasha Eva So what I said here is that Upadhidrishtya Bhavetu Chinmatra Brahma Eva Kevalam Bhasate Sakshi Na Bhasate Sakshi Iti Shabdena Na Bhasate Chinmatra Brahma Eva Kevalam Bhasate. That is the Aikya. Ataha Sakshi Api Brahma Eva. Sakshi is Brahma because there is no Sakshi. When Sakshya is not there, Sakshya is Mithya. The Triputi is Mithya. All the Koshas are Mithya. Shrota, Manta, Jnata is all, are all Mithya. The Vishwatejasa, Prajna is Mithya. They are all Mithya. There is no waker because there is no waking world. You cannot call yourself a waker. The Swapna is Mithya. You cannot be Tejasa, the dreamer. Vishwa is the waker. You cannot be the deep sleeper who has avidya because avidya going now. You know that you are not the waker Vishwa. You are not the dreamer Tejasa. You are not the deep sleeper Shushupti Abhimani Prajna also. That is why Turiya word has been used. Turiya means the fourth. So there are people who talk about, you know, there is a fourth. There is no fourth. There are no three to be fourth. The three are not there. How can you call fourth? Fourth is only as long as three are seen. With the Upadhi Drishti, with the Vishwa Upadhi, Taijasa Upadhi and Prajna Upadhi, meaning what? Abhimanis of Avasthatraya, considering them from their perspective, you say Turiya, fourth. The Turiya, fourth, need not be really fourth. There is no fourth. Fourth is not separate from the three. Fourth who pervades all three, who makes all three possible, cannot be separate as fourth. He is the whole. He is the Purna. Turiya is the Purna. Then the Turiya word should also drop off. People hold on to the word Turiya, considering that there is a fourth. There is no fourth. The earlier three taken, there is a fourth. When the three are taken as Mithya, then three not being there, there is no possibility of fourth. There is Ekameva Dvitiya who called earlier, who was called as Turiya earlier, now Brahma Eva. Similarly, Sakshi also, Sakshya falling away as Mithya, Brahma Eva. Yidrug Abhiprayana Eva Uktam Sakshi Eka Eva Iti. So from that Chinmatra Drishti, meaning Upadhi Drishti Abhave, there is only one Brahma who is called as Sakshi. And when Sakshi word was understood earlier, we reuse that word and say Sakshi Eka Eva Kasa Tad Brahma. Yataha Upadhi Prayukta Bheda Drishti Mantara Sakshinaha Anekatva Parichinnatvadikam Nasvato Abhavasate. Without, why so? Why Sakshi is one? Because without the Bheda due to Upadhi, Upadhi Krita Prayukta, Upadhi Prayukta Bheda. How is this Bheda possible without the Upadhi? And that Drishti of the Bheda was there earlier. Antara, this drishtim, tamantara, upadhi prayukta bheda drishtim antara, without that sakshina anekatva parichinnatvadikam nasvata ubhasate. What was accepted earlier? Yes, sakshi or jiva sakshi anekaha, and we said that parichinna api, parichinnascha. that was with upadhi prayukta bheda drishtim anu. Now that drishti is dropped off. Mithyatva nischaya is there. Upadhi prayukta bheda drishtim antara. We don't hold on to the earlier agreement of sakshina anekatva parichinnatvadikam. Na svata avabhasate brahma eva chinmatra brahma eva kevalam bhasate. Natu saksh anekatva parichinnatva. Natu anekatva parichinnatvadikam svataha na avabhasate. Ayam eva sakshi jiva So what I said, ayam eva sakshi, this very sakshi who is kevala now, jiva vachaka tvam pada lakshartaha. So the tattvamasi vakya in that tvam, tattvamasi he shweta ketu, there shweta ketu, you are that when it was said, that tvam, when analyzed, the vachyartha is shweta ketu. But Lakshartha is this very Sakshi, Evala Sakshi, Eka Eva Sakshi, Brahma Abhinna Sakshi, and thereby Tvampada Lakshartha being that Satchidananda Brahma, Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya, the Tatpada equation is possible. There the equation is with Ishvara Sakshi, not with Ishvara. Because Ishvara Sakshi is Nirguna Brahma. Ishvara is with the Ishvaratva Upadhi, Maya Upadhi. Uparishtad etat spashti kriyate. If it is not clear, Sadhu himself says, just take it at whatever you understand. This will be made clear as we go on. Right now we are still in the Anubandha Chatushtayam. Purvapakshi is raising questions, I am answering it, but he tells to his own students. All this will be clear later. It will be explained later as well. Ittham jiyo brahma ikyam asya grantasya vishaya iti uktam, yuktam eva uktam. Right now what has to be established is vishaya is jiyo brahma aikya. Purva Pakshi says aikya is not possible. I have explained, says Sadhu, that aikya is possible. That is the vishaya of this grantha. So vishaya is established as aikya and it is rightfully so. Now he moves on to prayojana vishayaka akshepaha. Na jnanena bandha nivritti iti akshepaha. Bandha nivritti cannot take place due to jnana. And this jnana is your prayojana. Moksha is your phala, prayojana, but jnana dvarena. So jnana is this grantha phala. Bandha satya iti akshepaha. So there, bandha will not go by jnana. Bandha cannot go at all because bandha is satya. Ahamkaryadi dehanta anatma bhuta drushya vastu jatam sarvam api bandha ityuchyate. First the Purva Pakshi is defining. What is this bandha? Bandha is ahamkara adi dehanta. Starting with ahamkara, ending with the stula deha. All of that is anatma. And in the form of this anatma, whatever is drishya vastu, the group of jatam, the group of drishya vastu, they are all called as sarvam api bandha iti uchyate. Ahankaradi dehanta anatma bhuta drishya vastu jatam sarvam api bandha iti uchyate. Sabandho yadi adhyasta syat tarhi jnanena nivartyeta. Only if this bandha itself was superimposed, meaning ahankara adi deha, all these had they been superimposed, adhyastha, then only they would go with jnana. Meaning bandha would go with jnana only if bandha itself is adhyastha, is superimposed. Anadhyasthaschet naiva jnanena nivartyeta. Had this bandha been adhyastha, it would have gone by jnana. It would go by jnana. But this, if it is anadhyastha, not superimposed, then it will not go by jnana. Jnanasya hi esha svabhavaha. So Purva Pakshi knows very well. What is the swabhava of jnana? Jnana can take away what is adhyasta, what is unknown through knowledge, that will be replaced. The ajnana will go. Ajnana alone, the adhyasa is possible due to ajnana, and jnana takes away ajnana, thereby adhyasta vastu goes away, which is not really a vastu, it is mithya. Jnanasya hi esha svabhava yat स्वविषयी भूत वस्तुनिष्ठ अज्ञान तत्कार्याध्यास निवर्तकत्वम् इति. व्हाट इज ज्ञान स्वभाव? स्वभाव ऑफ ज्ञान इज निवर्तकत्वम्. इट टेक्स अवे. व्हाट डज इट टेक अवे? इट टेक्स अवे अध्यास, विच इज अ कार्य ऑफ अज्ञान, एंड इट टेक्स अवे अज्ञान ऑल्सो. बिकॉज इट टेक्स अवे अज्ञान, इट टेक्स अवे अज्ञान कार्य ऑल्सो, विच इज अध्यास. सो इफ रज्जु अज्ञान गोज अवे, then the sarpa adhyasa will also go away with rajju ajnana, by rajju jnana. Where is this svavishayi bhuta vastunishta? It is there in the, this jnana is jnana vishayi bhuta. Jnana vishayi bhuta vastunishta ajnana. So rajju vishayi bhuta, in the example rajju vishayi bhuta vastunishta ajnana tatkarya adhyasa. In the rajju itself, there, so this ajnana which is there, jnana, whatever jnana you do not have, whatever vishayaka ajnana is there, that vishayaka jnana alone will take away, not any other jnana also. So that is the jnana svabhava. It will take away the ajnana regarding itself, and it will take away the ajnana karya. Yatha rajju sakshatkaraha. Through example, sadhu explains, yatha rajju sakshatkaraha. स्वविषयी भूत रज्ज्वध्यस्त सर्पादीन रज्ज्वज्ञानं च निवर्तयति. रज्जु साक्षात्कार इज ज्ञान, विच इज रज्जु ज्ञान. व्हाट विल इट टेक अवे? इट विल टेक अवे स्वविषयी भूत, मीन रज्जु साक्षात्कार इज स्वविषय. स्वविषय इज रज्जु इटसेल्फ. रज्जु विषयी भूत रज्ज्वध्यस्त सर्पादीन, sarpa ityadi, which is the bhranti there, they are all adhyasta. On what? On rajju itself. So rajju adhyasta. On the rajju itself, they are adhyasta. Rajju ajnanancha nivartayati. So takes away the rajju ajnana. Rajju jnana is rajju sakshatkara. That takes away rajju ajnana and its karya, which is sarpadin, which is adhyasta on the same rajju. It has to be adhyasta, otherwise it won't go. Brahmajnana vishayi bhuta mithyavastu tad vishayaka bhranti jnanam cha adhyasa ityuchyate. But I do not know what is adhyasa. So you are saying adhyasta, adhyasta. I need to know. So this rajju is the substratum on which sarpa is adhyasta. So sarpa, appearance of sarpa is what? There is adhyasa there. What is adhyasa? That is explained. Brahmajnana vishayi bhuta mithyavastu tad vishayaka bhranti jnanam cha adhyasa. The adhyasa is bhranti jnanam. Sarpa jnanam is adhyasa. Further it is explained. In the tippana it is said, adhyaso nama atasmin tad buddhihi. Bhagavan Bhashyakara explains this in Brahma Sutra. What is Adhyasa? Adhyasa Bhashya. Brahma Sutra in Adhyasa Bhashya. In Adhyasa Bhashya itself is on Adhyasa. So he says, Adhyaso nama atasmin tad buddhi. Atasmin means in non that. Tad buddhi means that, buddhi of that. There is a notion of that in non that. So in Sarpa, example of Sarpa, tad buddhi is Sarpa buddhi. And atasmin is non-sarpa. In asarpa, asarpe rajvam, asarpe rajav also. Both, I think both are possible there. So in non-sarpa rajju rope, there is sarpa buddhi. That is adhyasa. Atasmin, कालत्रयेपि सर्पाभाववति रज्ज्वादौ तद्बुद्धि प्रातिभासिक सर्पादि बुद्धि. ये एक्सप्लेन्स व्हाट इज अतस्मिन्. अतस्मिन् इज इक्वल टू कालत्रयेपि सर्पाभाववति. सर्पाभाववत् अभाववत् सर्पाभाव अस्य अस्ति इति सर्पाभाववत् सर्पाभाववति रज्ज्वादौ इन दैट रज्जु इत्यादि दंडा आल्सो समथिंग एल्स आल्सो माला माला बिकॉज माला ऑल हैज अ शेप दंडा विल बी स्ट्रेट भूछिद्र इन भूछिद्र और इन रज्जु और इन माला विच इज नॉन सर्प ऑल ऑफ दीज आर नॉन सर्प. सो सर्पा भाववती व्हेन कालत्रय अपि देर वॉज नेवर अ सर्प देर इज नो सर्प इवन व्हेन बीइंग सीन एंड देर वोंट बी अ सर्प लेटर ईदर इन द प्लेस ऑफ रज्जु इत्यादि. That is atasmin there. Atasmin kalatreyapi sarpabhavati rajvadau tad buddhi is pratibhasika sarpadi buddhi. So sarpa etc. whatever the rajju ityadi is seen. That is sarpa buddhi is atasmin tad buddhi. Tadrusha sarpadi tadjnanam cha adhyasa ityuchyate. That sarpadi and sarpajnanam. Sarpa is also adhyasa. And sarpajnana is also called as adhyasa. So adhyasa means two things. Atasmin tad buddhi. But that vishaya is also adhyasa. And jnana is also adhyasa. Therefore there are two types of adhyasas. Ayancha adhyaso dvividaha. Arthadhyaso jnana adhyasasche iti. There is adhyasa is also of two types. Arthadhyasa and jnana adhyasa. Bhranti jnana vishayi bhuta mithya sarpadhi arthadhyasa. What is arthadhyasa? Arthadhyasa is that mithya sarpadi. Bhranti jnana vishayi bhuta. What is the vishaya of the bhranti jnana? Bhranti jnana vishayi bhuta mithya sarpa. The sarpa. That sarpa is arthadhyasa. Whereas tadrusha mithyartha jnanam. This kind of a bhranti sarpa jnana is called as jnanadhyasa. So basically what I know sarpa as sarpa. I don't know Rajju as Rajju. I know Rajju as Sarpa. So Rajju appearing as Sarpa is Bhranti. So Sarpa is the Vishaya there. So that Vishaya is also Bhranti. And I know it as Sarpa. That Jnana is also Bhranti. Thereby that Arthadhyasa is Sarpa. And Sarpa Jnana is Jnana Adhyasa. So the technical differentiation made. As long as we understand the Adhyasa, it is fine. It will go away by Jnana. Therefore, Sarpa also goes and the Karya of Sarpa also goes because I know this as Sarpa, that also goes away. Sarpa will also go away. Sarpa Jnana will also go away when Rajju is known as Rajju. Idancha Jnanam Parokshatva Aparokshatva Dharma Bheda Dvividam. And this Jnana, what Jnana? This Jnana Adhyasa. That Jnana is also Dvivida, two types because Paroksha and Aparoksha. We have seen this paroksha jnana, aparoksha jnana, we already know. Tachyad vishayadhinam. Depending on the vishaya, this dvivida bheda is there. Jnana adhyasa eva mithya jnanam bhranti iti cha uchyate. This jnana adhyasa itself is called as mithya jnana. So when we talk about mithya jnana, bhranti, all we are talking about jnana adhyasa. So the sarpa bhranti is not the sarpa vishaya. There is no vishaya at all. That Vishaya is Adhyasa, but still the Jnana is also Adhyasa, Mithya Jnanam. So Sarpa Jnana is Mithya Jnana and that is Bhranti also, Sarpa Bhranti. Ite cha uchyate Arthadhyaso api Swarupadhyasa Samsargadhyasa Bhedena Dvividha. Arthadhyasa also, regarding that Vishaya also, Padartha, there is a division of whether it is Swarupadhyasa, Samsargadhyasa. A little more technical. We don't need this. Those who have studied Adhyasa Vashya, they may be able to follow. Otherwise, just understand for what it is right now. Dvivida, there are two types of Swarupadhyasa and Samsargadhyasa. Based on what is based on the Anuvritti, really based on the Anuvritti. Ajnana Tatkaryadinam Chetane Atmani Swarupadhyasa. Ajnana and its Karya. In Chetanatma. Where is the Ajnana? It is in Chetanatma. What about Ajnana Karya? That is also in Chetanatma. This much we know. this adhya, it is adhyasa or not? Yes, it is adhyasa. Ajnana and ajnana karya, ajnana is the vishaya there. Ajnana is the vishaya. The ajnana karya is also vishaya. Thereby it is artha, padartha. So artha being artha, artha is superimposed on atmani, atma. And seen in atma, it is swarupa adhyasa. Because ajnana and karya is not really there. So when you see ajnana and tatkarya in atma, it is swarupa adhyasa. Satchidananda rupasya atmana ajnana tatkaryadav samsarga adhyasam atram. Here what happens is that the atma is definitely there. What is bhranta vishaya, bhranti vishaya, that is superimposed on existent chetana vastu. So therefore it is called as swarupadhyasa. But the other way around, the mix-up is other way around also. Atma being chetana, the chetanatvam is lent to karya, ajnana karya. What about the other way around? If you analyze it, there also there is adhyasa. The chetana is adhyasta on karya. Karya is adhyasta on chetana. So the other way, if you analyze, in karya, what is the adhyasa? What type of adhyasa it is there? Satchidananda rupasya atmana. This Satchidananda chetana vastunaha atmanaha. Ajnana tatkarya. In ajnana and in tatkarya. In its karya, ajnana karya. Samsarga adhyasa matram. There is only samsarga adhyasa. So anyway, he stops the analysis here. We'll also continue with the Mula. So in Mula, it is said this adhyasa is defined as what? It is this much we, if we understand from the Tippana, that is sufficient for now. Atasmin tadbuddhi is adhyasa. Wherever there is no that, there isn't that. In that, in non that, there is buddhi of that. And that being the pronoun, it can be replaced with anything. So in non sarpa, you see sarpa. In non rope, you see rope. The adhishtana can be anything. There will be some similarity, but there is adhyasa. Meaning, in non-rope, you see rope. In non-snake, you see snake. In non-silver, you see silver. That is adhyasa. In non-chetana, you see chetana. In sharira, that is adhyasa. In this mithya vastu, you see satyatvam. That is all adhyasa. Thereby, what is said here is that brahmajnana vishayi bhuta mithya vastu tad vishayaka bhranti jnanam cha adhyasa ityuchyate. There is arthadhyasa and jnanadhyasa based on brahmajnana vishaya. Vishayi bhuta mithya vastu, that vishayi bhuta mithya vastu is what it is adhyasa, and tad vishayaka bhranti jnana is also adhyasa. So they have two types of adhyasa. Iti cha uchyate yatra yadvastu mithyatvam antara paramarthato vartate nasti tasya jnanat nivrittihi. So the objection is bandha satya and then jnanena bandha nivrittihi na bhavati. Now sadhu is looking at it from the purvapakshi's angle. Yatra yadvastu mithyatvam antara paramarthato vartate nasti tasya jnanat nivrittihi. Wherever there is the vastu, paramarthata, it is there, really there, without the mithyatva, it will not go away by jnana. Evam atmani api ahankaradi bandha yadi adhyasta syat tari jnane nivartyeta. Had these been ahankara ityadi bandha, had it been superimposed on atma adhyasta, then they would have gone. Jnanena, through jnana, atmani mithya bhuta bandhadhyasa samagri nasti. But what is he saying? Had they been so, they would have gone. But it is not so. That is what the Purvapakshi is saying. Ahankara ityadi are not superimposed on atma. They are not adhyasta on atma. They are there. Satya, they are there. And if you say no, they are mithya, then you have to explain what is the samagri for mithya. Atmani mithya bhuta bandhadhyasa. Mithya bhuta bandha, if it is mithya, in atma it is adhyasta, then you have to explain what is the samagri. How did you cook up this mithyatva? How did it come about? Mithya bhuta bandhadhyasa samagri nasti atmani. Tathapi atmani pratiyete cha bandha. See, if there is no samagri and you have pratiti, we keep on saying there is a pratiti of bandha, bandha is mithya. Then the Purvapakshi says, okay, there is a pratiti, you agree, right? That much you agree that there is pratiti of bandha. Sharira pratiti is there. Now, if without the samagri, there cannot be mithyatva of the pratiti. Therefore, pratiti is real. Otherwise, you have to prove the samagri of pratiti. How did it come about? Tasmad bandha satya eva bhavitum arhati satyatvadeva jnanena bandha nivrityasha nirarthika eva. Thereby what Purvapakshi is established is bandha is satya. Why? Samagri abhavat. Samagri nam abhava. There is no samagri to establish mithyatvam of this bandha, and bandha is what? Ahankaradi dehanta. Anatma. What you say as anatma, anatma. He is using Siddhanti's terminology. You call what you call as anatma is nothing but ahankaradi dehanta, starting with ahankara, ending with deha. All dehas, so vishwa, whatever this is, in it is superimposed on atma. If you say, you agree that there is pratiti, but if you say it is superimposed and therefore mithya, then you have to show me the samagri for mithya. And samagri bhavat na mithya, therefore satyah, therefore ahankaradi dehanta bandha satya, satya eva bhavitum arhati, kutaha mithyatva bhavat. Mithyatva bhava kutaha, why do you say mithyatva bhava? Samagri bhavat. Now unless we establish samagri, mithyatvam cannot be established. And if mithyatvam cannot be established, bandha is satya. If bandha is satya, satyatvadeva bandhasya. Ahankaradi dehanta. If you start with deha also, dehadi ahankaranta. You have to say ahankaranta then. But let's use the same words. Ahankaradi dehanta bandha bandhasya satyatvad. So ahankaradi dehantasya satyatvat, which is bandha rupa. So bandhasya satyatvat eva jnanena bandha nivritya asha nirarthika. Even to have hope that you will have moksha by bandha nivritti, and that bandha nivritti is through jnana, because jnana will take away ajnana and ajnana karya being mithya, that cannot be established. Jnana will not give you moksha because bandha is satya. This is what the Purvapakshi has established. Now adhyasa samagriya will be discussed as to what are the samagris for adhyasa which are needed. Purvapakshi is going to discuss this. Siddhanti talks about all this. He says these are the samagris. Now show which are all these samagris there. All these samagris you should be able to show me. Then alone I will accept that this bandha is mithya, dehadi, ahankaradi dehanta, they are bandhabhuta, they are mithya, and being mithya, adhyasta, they will go away by jnana. And then you can say jnanena moksha, and you can establish this prayojana, vishayaka, akshepa can be refuted. We'll look at that in the next part. Huh? Sukam nityam saprakasham vyapakam nama rupyo adhishtanam buddhya bodhyam buddhir drukyattu nirmiram aparam sarva vedanta vedyam pratyak paramaha tadevahannamattu anyat iti menishchitamatihi. Any questions? Namaste, I'll see you in the next part.
Hari Om.
हरिओम
हरिओम.